Ravinder, how is the government dealing with this spike?
Well, at the moment, with the second wave, becoming higher than what was assumed, things are actually spiraling out of hand. State governments, central governments are scrambling to, meet the demand, whether it is of the oxygen, whether it is the hospital beds, ICU beds, even ventilators, and even medicines. You know, Remdesivir, which is the antiviral drug which was manufactured in India, the manufacturing had been decreased from November to January, which was a period of lull, which was the time when actually the government's had to ramp up preparing for the second wave, but that did not happen as far as the governments are concerned. People became complacent from November to January, thinking there is no virus, and look what is happening now. It has come back with a vengeance. People were not following COVID-appropriate behavior, and now there is a shortage of basic requirements to actually treat those who are infected by the virus. So that is the situation. Vaccination drive, as it was being said that India is the manufacturer of vaccines, it's now actually importing vaccines in order to meet the domestic demand. The domestic demand has gone higher. Initially, it started with a vaccine hesitancy, but now people are lining up to get themselves vaccinated, but there aren't enough doses available, and so all the state governments are requesting the central government to provide them with the vaccination doses, and that has started a vaccination politics in the country. While people are suffering, the political parties are getting into a blame game with each other, and there is the situation on the ground is really worrisome. Zongshi,
CDTN's Ravinder Bawa in Delhi.